Get your raffle take it out.
For coming out and supporting the Pittsburgh Black Family Reunion. All right, our next raffle is coming up. It is the 50-50 raffle. It is a red ticket. Pot is $287, I believe.
That's it?
All right, let's see who has the lucky ticket. I don't think that we're spoiling the pot. All right, he's got the winner. Ticket number 591573.
Right.
Again, 591573. Who is the lucky winner of $287? Check your tickets. Check your tickets. Okay. And now pick again. Going once. Going twice. 591573. Who's running? Who's running from way in the back of the field? I need for you to put some hustle on it for this $287. The band members behind me are saying that their fingers are getting pretty itchy back here for this money. So I believe we do have a rare. I see him running. He's coming. My man in the yellow. He got some hustle. Somebody gonna have to get this man a bottle of water by the time he's done getting to the stage. Somebody get this man a bottle of water.
Hey,
don't worry, we won't give your money away. Come on up here and meet me at the corner of the stage so I can give you your prize winning. And I appreciate for everyone that purchased a ticket today for the 50-50. We appreciate you. We love you. Thank you for your support. Thank you again for coming out and supporting the 14th Annual Pittsburgh Black Family Reunion. I hope you guys are having a blast today. We enjoyed your company, love seeing everybody dance, having a good old time. Enough, you can celebrate when you get to the stage. Come on up here. You ran a long way, and you still ain't got here yet. Come on, my man. I know. He pulled an OJ. Yes, my man gets a bottle. I know he gets a bottle of water. My man. Everybody, give this man a round of applause for right now. Football field away to come get this $287. What's your name?
Frank Stan.
Nice to meet you, Frank. Thank you for running all that way. Check your tickets. I wasn't going to give it away. He's got it. And here you go. You are so welcome. $287 for the ticket. And thank you for coming. Hey, give him a round of applause. All right, coming up to the stage, I am going to bring up the CEO and founder of Community Empowerment Association, and he is going to give you information and a little bit of history about what the program stands for and what he means in our community. Come on up, Brother Rashad Birdsong. Let's give him a round of applause. Y'all can do better than that.
Y'all better do better than that. We've been hustling for 14 years to put stuff like this together for black folks in Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh, how you feel? Pittsburgh, how you feel? Are y'all enjoying yourselves? Now y'all know when family get together, we like to eat, we like to celebrate, we like to take pictures. But also, families get together and do an analysis and an assessment of what's been going on in the family. Now, we have to talk a little bit about the black family and the conditions and the circumstances that we find ourselves in. Because tomorrow, we're going to continue to hear about the violence in our community. Tomorrow, we're going to continue to hear about the young boys and women dying in the street. Tomorrow, we're going to continue to have President Trump in office. Hopefully that's going to be a short term, but he's in office today. Before I move any further, what I like to do is, as y'all know, there was a situation in Virginia yesterday where you had innocent protesters and black folks that were protesting for social justice in this country. And you had some Nazis and some skinheads run the car right into the protesters, and unfortunately there was a young black woman that died in that incident. So just for a moment, I'd like us to have a silence for all of the black folks that have died in this country, sisters of the violence, and the sister that died yesterday. Just a moment of silence, please. Thank you. There's an African saying that until the last person says your name, then you're dead. We have to continue to have remembrance of all of the freedom fighters whose shoulders that we stand on today. We also got to remember our remembrance of all the brothers and sisters that's political prisoners that's locked up in this country today. We also got to remember multi-millions of black boys and women and brown boys and women that's incarcerated in this country today. We got to continue to remember that the psychotropic drugs that they give your black boys so they can manage them and prepare them for the pipeline of prison. So despite us coming together and enjoying ourselves, brothers and sisters, we got some hard work that we got to do. Tomorrow we all have to reach out and touch somebody. Have to reach out and knock on somebody's door. Because there is a collective trauma that impacted the black community, and we have particularly women folks hiding behind locked doors that's traumatized and scared to see the kids in the street. This is a call to black men, because it's going to take strong black men to get out in those streets and start accessing young boys out there. Because we are the men in our community. We have to set the example. Unfortunately, black men have become an endangered species. That means that, you know, there's an absence of black men in the family. So that means, sisters, wherever that part of the black man might be, whether it's in the masjid, whether it's in the mosque, whether it's in the temple, whether it's in the church, whether he's a barber down the street, we gonna have to call these brothers on stuff. Because I remember that everybody in the black community was responsible for the child care and parental upkeep of our black children. Y'all remember them days? There was a code in the street, remember? The code in the street said you did not harm no women. The code in the street said you did not harm no children. And you got to remember the code of you can't shit where you eat. I think that some of us forgot that. So we'd like for everybody to enjoy themselves. And the theme of this year is the value and the state of black life. And I don't necessarily mean just the violence in the street. I mean educational violence. Black boys being pushed out of school. economic violence, and gentrification of the black community. All these things are violent, brothers and sisters. So we're going to have to take a page out of the 60s, where you had revolutionary brothers and sisters that took a stand on social justice and liberation and standing on the heavy shoulders of our ancestors. Those are the examples that we have to set for young people. So in ending, I'm going to say that we want you to continue to come out and enjoy yourself. Community Power Association, I want everybody to Google us up when we leave here tonight. Google up Community Power Association and Google up Rashard Birdsong, and I want y'all guys to like me, because we have to be able to communicate with one another. We're not doing a good job of that. So this is part of being able to communicate. Also, freedom is not free. We're a small grassroots organization that 14 years ago, when there was no type of culture going on in Pittsburgh at all, we say that we're going to have black culture just like this year. We pulled our nickels together to get it. Don't think we got no corporate rights folks that sponsor this year. We have to sponsor this ourselves. So if you enjoy what you're involved in this evening, make sure that you make a donation to the Community Power Association and some of those other nonprofits that are going to be a door to serve the black people. Thank you.
Thank you.